The shell of one. A shell. A car. A tar. A shell. A car. A car shell. Aloha. Aloha. A car shell. Ohana. Mbafu. Hope. Hi, loved ones. Okay, so I want you to go get a piece of paper so you can participate. Something to write on and something to write with. I'm going to write with an incense stick because I don't feel like writing with a pen. I like utilizing earth-based items to write. And I'm going to take a moment to share this out to some places. Happy, happy, blessed loves. How are you all feeling? How are you doing? Wellness. That was my attempt to say prayers of wellness. I'm like, wellness. What the heck was that? Mix just three words together, get it out of the way. All right, so this is about sacred. That's all I'm gonna put on there. If you want to share this out to places you feel could benefit from the ceremony, I give you permission to, if it's in the most high intentions, to bring about bliss to you. Activations of self and we-ness, that beautiful integration of light, of peace and purity within. I'm going to have you write on the paper, before we begin, action plan. On the very top, action plan. Underneath that, you'll write, major steps to achieve my goals. And do a 1, 2, and 3. Just keep it as like prioritize. So it's comprehended, yeah. We prioritize to bring in the medicine of now for now. So what could happen? And then what are some challenges that you may face? And with that one, you're gonna rip that one in half and separate it. So you write that one and you will erase over it. And you will erase over it with positive affirmations to undo those things. If you feel like someone's not going to accept your decisions and you feel that your decisions are sound and sane, and you have everything that you need, you have to trust and believe in yourselves. So if you feel like there might be challenges, I want you to look those challenges in the face and say, well, what can I do to integrate so that those challenges are not so challenging? Because on the journey, on the path, we must have our lessons in bliss. And bliss is finding the positive, finding the keys, finding the shiny part in every single experience and situation, so that there are positive memories, positive aspects. If you can find something, you know. I'm sure I went fishing far too long as a child. We just kind of sat around and wait for the fish to bite. I'd sing and they'd come. But you just kind of acknowledge that. What are you looking for? What are you fishing for? What are you using as bait? And how are you accomplishing that task and that goal? I am vegan now, just by the way. So then the next side, you want to write goals for today, goals for tomorrow, and goals for the future. Now remember, you're going to be ripping that part off. So you want to make sure to do the goals right in the very right, 1, 2, 3, and then there's 1, 2, 3 on the back side. And while I'm singing and doing the ceremony, I welcome you to embrace and do that. I will do mine in the moments that I do, but this is the moments to share. So take a moment, feel into the bliss, centering and expanding as we do the ceremony. I bring in the blessings of sacred waters, Aurus, the wombs of creation. Into the waters of the seas, into the oceans, into the rivers, into the springs, into the purity that exists within the waters we sing. Let it be, let it be, let the waters be free. Let the urus shine bright, healed with light. Into the waters within we flowing through our bodies, through our blood, through our vessels that we heal, purification, expanding. I welcome you to take the waters if you have from the Urus, and let them be welcomed as we do this ceremony. Thank you. allow the waves to wash us through this ceremony. Calling to the spirits and the lights and the expansions that we be with this miracle drum, sacredly created for miracles and blessings by a divine loved one who's a Shemaiah of one of our Mayan kindreds and other roots. With the deer and the sacred buffalo and the cedar, and inappropriately, I do not have the wand as it was lost in the waves when I went there for ceremony. Peacefulness we've got to hold, for we are the way. Opening up the eyes to the soul, to the heart, to the consciousness, to the vessels. Putting away the past experiences and sufferings to embrace and love the present moments. Breathe in really deeply, even if you're writing. experiences, you might be feeling some changes. Purification, and those of you who have things going on in your homes, we're doing being vibrating light, so open up the speakers, turn them up loud. Now, I think it's really important. So may you enjoy it. May we have this moment sacred.
Oh.
of our intentions to improve ourselves from the inside out. Transforming continuously. So I want you to take your pen, if you have a pen. I'm going to light this on fire. Thank you, Chlorophyll Synchronous Records. And one of his beautiful, happy artists. I have to learn. They need to put like the titles of them on there. I realize I'm a seer, but geez. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to light this incense, right? Just a bit. Let it burn a little bit, and then I can write with it. And this is real roses, crushed roses. I was gifted this by a Rasta priest. So it's like magical too, and it can't be unenchanted into a negative experience. It can only be for positive. So now it's lit, and I'm gonna use my other one. I don't suggest children play with the fire like this, but as adults, I think it's okay. If you're on heavy medication, don't try it. If you're on like a lot of medication, okay? Or if you smoked an entire blunt or something, or a whole glass of bottle of wine, you just want to be really careful. Okay, let's see. Or if you can't see, you don't want to do it either. Okay, so I'm gonna put this right here. Okay, ready? Now that one's lit. There. Okay, I'm ready. So you write action plan on the very top of the paper. You want to make sure that you write 1, 2, 3 on both sides. You want to, the other side you're going to put today, tomorrow, and the future. But on the side that you put action plan, you want to put 1, 2, 3. Somebody tried to block the live. That's weird. Okay, so you're going to write major steps to achieve my goals. Ready? Okay. So one of the things that you can do is put what you need to do to achieve a certain goal. Like me, I have funders, so I'm gonna really say what's happening. There's those who are willing to invest in all of the land that has been gifted to create sustainability on and solutions. And they are excited to work with us. And they are investing in us. And what I'm going to do to make sure that that happens is write up the business plans, talk to them, show them what I'm looking at for them to invest in, how much they need to invest into what part and what program and what portion of it. The second thing I'm going to do, probably, I'm not going to write really what I'm going to write on there, but pertaining to that, I'm already working hard. The second thing that I would put on there, if it was, you know, for business purposes, practically, I would probably put, have weekly meetings with each location and the teams who can help us build there. And for number three, I would probably put, make moments for each business, each property, each company, based on priority and organize it where I work on that each day, each one. I have like certain ones that I work on each day. So I'm already consciously putting that into my consciousness. And then what you want to do is write it. So 1, 2, and 3, and then the next one, you're going to have to rip this that page off. Not yet, though. You put, what are some challenges that you feel that you might face? And what are integrations that you can put into it so that you are not, I really don't like using burning plastic, so, or aluminum. I'm just going to let it burn, then I guess, where do I put this at? So I'll just keep, babysitting it. Okay, the next is, what are some challenges that you might face? And when you think of challenges, you want to make sure that you look at it in the face and you say, well, why are those challenges? And how do I integrate if there's a challenge? Does that mean that there's somebody else involved and it's messing with their destiny to just like change it? Acknowledge what has to happen as an integration for that change to occur, because there has to be an integration. And you want to make sure that after you do that, you erase that. And then you rip it off and you write over it positive affirmations to help you work through those. Because you think about it. Dang, this is important. I feel like I'm getting, you know, Rasta did make this. I wonder if it's mixed with cannabis. No, it smells like roses. Okay. You gotta be careful if someone wants, you know. So what are some challenges that you might face through that? And just really, when you tear that off, you want to tear it off in the direction of tearing it away from you. And on the other side, you'll have today, tomorrow, and the future. And what it says on top of that is goals for. So there you have it. I'm going to take a moment to put mine over here. I don't want to do it on live video. On video, that'd be really, it's not as private. So I'm going to do a cleansing and a clearing. Take a moment to breathe into the heart center, to the soul center, really looking at what you wrote. You've had some moments now to write and to really feel into the vibration. Consciously aware, where's your heart space, where's your consciousness, where's your body feeling? Asha Adonai, oh, oh. All right, beloveds, it's so beautiful to see you again. It's so beautiful to get to have moments together and ceremony together. We thank the ancestors and the loved ones who have come forward with us, the archangels, all the beautiful loved ones in the multi-realms that love us so deeply. Galactically and spiritually, as well as emotionally, physically, consciously, that we acknowledge that love, and we are so thankful for each of you, and also for those who are present with us lovingly. We give a beautiful, bright, shiny embrace of purification from hard experiences that can heal and allow forgiveness. We open up that intention to really wash through the consciousness and the heart experiences to bring about forgiveness, because beings do change. So much light, washing in, purifying again. Asha, beloved ones. Thank you. Mahalo. I don't want to catch my carpet on fire, so don't let me forget the incense. Thank you. You're welcome. I'll see you again. I just gotta change my dress and put some things away, and then I'll come on again and do something else. I'll see you soon, love. And this crown is tight, so I'll see you soon. Bye. Blessed love. I love you. I love you. I love you. I love you. Akasha.